Hello everyone, in this video, I'll delve into the top 5 standout features debuting with the initial GIMP 3.0 release. Number 1, non-destructive editing. GIMP 3.0 will finally see the introduction of non-destructive editing. This upgrade will allow users to apply their adjustments or effects to their photos, then go back at any time and reopen the settings of their effects to tweak or remove settings. This is in contrast to the old behavior where effects were applied directly to the image and couldn't be edited later in your workflow. To utilize non-destructive editing in GIMP 3.0, simply add your effect to a layer such as the levels adjustment, and a small FX icon will appear in the layers panel next to that layer. When you want to make a change to the effect, click the icon to see a small pop-up dialog, then click on the effect you want to edit, tweak the settings, then click OK to reapply them. Non-destructive editing drastically improves photo editing as it allows you to go back and make adjustments to filters without worrying about the order those filters were applied. As new filters or effects are added to your image and affect your image's color, you can go back and tweak any filter settings to get an optimal result. Number 2, dynamic guides or smart guides. GIMP 3.0 will have dynamic guides, more commonly referred to as smart guides, that help users align objects on their canvas in real time as those objects are clicked and dragged around the composition. These dynamic guides allow you to align or snap objects to one another based on their bounding boxes, displaying a guide only when bounding boxes align at their sides or center. To enable dynamic guides, go to the View menu and check the box labeled Snap to Bounding Boxes, then use your Move tool to click and drag a layer and snap it to the bounding box of another layer. This feature also allows you to quickly and evenly space objects on your composition. Just go to View, Snap to Equidistance, and dynamic guides will appear that indicate when multiple objects are evenly spaced on your canvas. Number 3, CMYK Support. While GIMP 3.0 won't have full CMYK support, meaning you won't technically be editing your photos in a CMYK color space, it will offer much more robust CMYK support right out of the box that will help users prepare compositions for print or send their edits off to a printing company. That's because GIMP 3.0 will support what's known as a late binding workflow. In this type of CMYK workflow, you can import your CMYK images, import a CMYK color profile for soft proofing, meaning you can edit photos in an RGB color space, but preview roughly what your edits will look like when converted to a CMYK color space, then export your edited compositions with a CMYK color profile attached to the image to send to a printer. Early binding CMYK workflows where you can edit your image's color in a true CMYK color space are the preferred method for editing images for print, but late binding workflows are a sufficient workaround for the time being. So GIMP users will have a lot more capability in terms of working with CMYK-based images in GIMP 3.0. Number 4, outline text. In GIMP 3.0, the headache of adding stroke to text disappears with the introduction of the outline text feature built directly into the text tool. With this feature, you can now non-destructively add a stroke to your text and make adjustments to the stroke in real time. To use the feature, grab the text tool from the toolbox, then click on your canvas and start typing your text. In the tool options, set the style to outlined or outlined and filled using the dropdown. Outline options will now appear below the dropdown, and you can make adjustments to things like the color, line width, and dash pattern, and of course you can go back at any time and make adjustments to these settings. Adding strokes to your text and styling those strokes will now be easier than ever in GIMP 3.0. Number 5, multi-layer features and layer sets. GIMP 3.0 will introduce the highly anticipated multi-layer selection and multi-layer aware features. Users will be able to simply shift-click or control-click to select multiple layers in the layers panel, then move, delete, or add effects to those layers. Another cool feature that results from this new functionality and is rolling out with GIMP 3.0 is something called layer sets. Layer sets are a way to tag or label multiple selected layers, then select all those tagged layers simultaneously at any point during your workflow. To use this feature, select the layers you want to add to the layer set, then click the magnifying glass icon towards the top right corner of the layers panel. Type the name of your new layer set in the bottom text field, then click the plus icon. on. Your layer set will now be stored, and next time you need to select the layers from the layer set, you can click the magnifying glass icon and click on the stored layer set. These are just a few of the many exciting features making their way into the hopefully soon to be released GIMP 3.0 stable release. But that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video, including a link to my GIMP Masterclass. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.